Hi Aries, welcome to Miracle the Tribe. My name is Ayushi and this is going to be for Aries Sun, Moon and Rising for the month of November 2018. So let's see what are the messages coming up for Aries Sun, Moon, Rising. This is going to be a 10 card Celtic cross. Guys, keep in mind that you use your own intuition and understand that energies are fluid, so it may resonate before November or even after November. Keep in mind that not all the messages are going to resonate to you since it is a general reading. So let's see what's coming up for Aries. The first card out for you is the Hangman. So the Hangman and the bottom of the deck here is the Four of Pentacles. So I see that that financially you are trying to save some money. Some of you are trying to save, or you are trying to understand you're trying to understand how can I restrict my resources in a way that you don't want to share it because you feel that you have less money. So that's why you are trying to be very mindful of how you are spending your money. Also, this is telling me that you are holding back your emotions and desires, not sharing it with other people in a greedy way. Now, I'm saying in a greedy way, maybe that is because you feel that in order to feel fulfilled, you have to keep something for yourself, and that is why you are protecting yourself in a way that you are holding back something within yourself and not sharing it with other people. Now, I'm also getting that some of you are doing it because of a spiritual calling. Like, you feel that a certain situation has pushed you in a state of isolation where you can't help but retreat and look for answers in obscure places. Like you never thought you will be looking for such answers in places that you are looking right now. Like you are probably you're reading, you're researching and doing something of that nature because you want to totally understand the situation that you're going through. So you're doing everything to understand the situation from different perspective. And you understand now that how you have been looking at a certain situation, it's not working. And that's why you need to change your belief system or your ideas about it so that you can understand the situation that you're dealing with in a better way. So let's see what's coming up for Aries Sun, Moon, Rising. 10 card Celtic cross. 10 card Celtic cross for Aries Sun, Moon and Rising for November 2018. Okay, let's cut the deck. So your heart of the matter, you have two cards, Seven of Pentacles and Three of Cups. So what I'm getting here is that you feel that when it comes to your friendships or your friend circle, you want to assess with whom you are spending your time and how much time you are spending with these people. There can be a three-party situation and you are wondering which person to go with, which person to choose, and you are understanding how far can I invest more in this situation, or is it a right moment to pull myself back. I'm also getting here that there is something that needs to be celebrated. Now, I don't know what that is, but when it comes to friendship, there is something, some sort of celebration. Or it can be that your friends are gossiping about something, but still I feel that it's something happy. I don't know why, like it's a contradictory message here. I'm feeling that there is something to be celebrated in the month of November. However, there is something that you need to be very cautious about, because like there is some investment that you are doing in terms of money, energy or whatever, which might go to waste when it comes to a group of people, like spending time with friends or something like that. It might go to waste and you are just considering, should I go further with the investment or not. What's crossing you is the moon card. So yes, you are looking for something outside what you already have. Like whatever the situation is, you are looking for something outside of it. Like you feel that there is something to be discovered beside what you are facing right now, because you feel there is some mystery going on and there is something that is being kept hidden from you. So you want to discover what that thing is, and it can be a higher calling for some of you. Like you feel that something, like you have an inner calling, so you might feel that. What the root of this reading is the Five of Wands, and the present past energy is Ten of Wands. So Five of Wands in the root energy and Ten of Wands in the past energy. I'm also getting that some of you are finding it challenging to choose between two options or two people or two jobs, something of that nature. There is some competition as well, and there is a lot of destructive ideas and energies around you, and you have to fight this distraction or this competition, or you are distracted in your own head and you're not able to make up your mind and you're relying on your friends, or this is a decision related to your friends. Something of that nature is coming up. In past, there was something that was burdening you, which was holding you back. Not holding you back. It was burdening you in a way that you felt depressed or very exhausted. You almost felt like you can't see further. You almost felt like, I don't know where to go from here because I cannot see anything. So it can be that in past you are doing a lot of physical and mental, mostly I'm getting physical effort. You are making physical effort and you are feeling very drained in past. What's on your mind is the Father of Pentacles, and what's in your future is the Nine of Cups. So what I'm getting here is that in past you were feeling very exhausted and burdened. In present moment you are feeling, how much should I invest more in this situation, whatever situation that it is. And in future I'm seeing that you will have a wish fulfillment, but you have to be very mindful of what you're wishing for, because whatever that you will invest in, that might come true, and it will give you some sort of satisfaction, like finally I did it or something like that. It can be also that you are partying with some people and there is somebody who can be a little bit addictive or addicted to something. Now on your mind you want to be or you're dealing with someone who is a very stable person, someone who has like someone who is set in reality, someone who is practical, someone who is working hard towards achieving their desires, and they are working really hard, and this person can be very accomplished. Now this person is very like fatherly figure, so it can be your father as well. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, anyone of that sort. You also have a Pisces person here, Sun, Moon, Rising. Or you're wanting to be financially stable is one of the messages that I'm getting, and there is a lot of hesitation that I'm getting here. Like you feel that my energies are distracted, you're feeling that I'm exhausted, you're feeling that should I invest my more energy somewhere, can I rely on my friends or other people. You are thinking about how can I build a solid foundation. So probably that is why you will have to retreat back and go within and look for answers within, and you will have to be very mindful and a little bit stingy or greedy with respect to your money. You will have to save some money is what I'm getting here. In how you come up in this reading is the Five of Swords, and someone around you is coming up as Nine of Pentacles. Your hopes and fears is the Wheel of Fortune, and your outcome card is the Sun of Swords. So what I'm getting here is that people see you as somebody who is cutting somebody out, or you are fighting a battle which is futile. Like you are in a battle which is, it can be an ego battle, but it's a futile battle. There is no use fighting this battle, and it may be something bitter. Like you will feel bitter about this, and the other person will feel bitter about this. But I'm getting that maybe you will win this fight, whatever. But there will be a lot of cord cutting or the severances of ties that I'm getting here, and either you will become single or someone around you will become single, or there is someone who is happily single here, or you will do this because you want to be happily single, or somebody else around you wants to be like that. And mostly I'm getting that there is something related to finances. What you fear or what you hope is that things will turn into your favor. So that is your, like, you're hoping that things will turn out in your favor after whatever happens here. And as an outcome, I'm getting that maybe in the month of November, you will get somebody who will bring you a message, or someone who is stalking you, or you will stalk this person. But someone is stalking or researching about you, or you are researching about somebody else, or somebody is thinking about bringing you a message. But it's not quite clear if they will bring you a message. They are just looking for a moment to, like, they are looking for a right moment or a right mood when they can bring you a message. So let's see what's the bottom of the deck. Bottom of the deck is the Two of Swords. So like I was saying, there is some decision that you have to make. Maybe you are making a decision regarding, should I move on from something or should I not? And for this decision to be made, you are feeling right now very stuck, like you cannot move or take any action or make any changes in your life, which is not true. You can do whatever you want and everything is in your hands. In fact, I'm also getting here the Fool card. So for some of you, there is a new beginning that needs to happen. So you need to trust yourself and the universe and your potential and your skills. Like some of you will even have to learn things along the way, so there is no point of holding yourself back, and come out of this hesitation that you are feeling. I'm also having a High Priestess here. So High Priestess is telling me that there is definitely something that is going in your mind, and you know it deep within your soul, that needs to happen. Now whatever that thing is, or whatever that decision is, that will have to be made, like, you know, that needs to be taken, or that decision needs to be made from your soul. So that's the message that I'm getting right now. Let's see if there is something else that we can get. Messages for Aries. Messages for Aries. Bittersweet. So, Aries, what I'm getting here is that maybe there is some experience that you are facing here, and victim is also what I'm getting here. So, what I'm getting here is that some of you are, first of all, not feeling like you want to take any action. You are in a very complacent space, like things are going the way, like, you know, things are just passing by and you're not doing anything. Because you're stuck between, should I take this action or not? Should I start something or not? This is the Fool card. Should I begin a new journey or a new something? So you are still very hesitant, and you feel that you don't have much information, or you don't feel that you're very much supported. So that's going on, and you're also very not able to decide, should I move on, should I leave the things that are obstructing me. So you might be getting affected by that. And Bittersweet is telling me that maybe there is something that you really can't leave behind, or you cannot get get past without breaking ties with people around you. It can be a bitter experience, but maybe after you are done dealing with these people, and if you are, when you are done shedding these people from your life, you will have a sweet journey that you can begin. And this entire process might feel like a bittersweet phase of your life, where you are not entirely happy with your decision, but at the same time you know that whatever decision that you are making right now is for your benefit, or it will be beneficial in your future. So that's the message that I'm getting, Aries. One oracle card for Aries. Sacred Fool. So another card that comes out is Fool again. So maybe there is definitely a journey. For some of you it's a spiritual journey. So Sacred Fool is, you might feel foolish for a while, whatever way you take, and you might even feel like, you know, you might feel like you are a puppet in the hands of destiny or God or whatever. But right now, it's very important for you to understand that you have free will, and you can make your own decisions and you can make your own choices. And even though you will feel like a fool if you start something new which is not being supported by other people, it will be helpful for you in a long run, and listening to the truth. So I'm getting that if you will listen and close your eyes and listen to your heart and what your soul has to say and communicate to you, you will listen to the truth of your soul, and that's how you can live your authentic life without the fear of judgment, or without expecting anybody else to support you on your path, because you will be self-sufficient just on your own. So that was your reading, Aries. I hope this was helpful. I'll see you next month. Bye-bye.